Namaskar children, in today's video we will do hyperlink where we will use image. That is, if you click on an image, it will turn into a hyperlink and it will take you to another part of the web page. In the previous video we did text as hyperlink, and today's one we will do image as hyperlink. So for that we have to open the code that we did earlier. Suppose this code where you have used go back text in order to go to the page link, if you remember. So over here, instead of writing this particular text, the tag is same, a tag is there, anchor tag, href hyperlink reference, it will take you to the page link.htm, and the title, that is when you take the cursor on the hyperlink, the title is open link page. And what you will click, instead of clicking on the text, we can click on the image, which will take you to the page link.htm. In order to insert the image over there, we will use the similar tag, that is img src, and give the image name. Now the image name that we the image that we have stored in our document, I mean our folder, is fish. There is no other image that is there in our document, so you can use this fish image only, which can be used as the hyperlink. So insert fish.jpg. Since it is a very big picture, you can give a width and height, it will make you small. Width say 50 and say height is also 50. Actually it will be better if you give 30, so right, 30 and 30 you give, it will be smaller. So this is how the image tag is used. Backslash img is not required, backslash anchor is required. So let us see how it works. Just save it, because it's earlier saved properly, so we are just going on to save. Normal save, no save as is required, because it was earlier saved with .htm extension already. So we've just made the change, that's why no need to go to .htm and renaming once more. Just open this image web page. So you can see this particular image, 30 and 30 size. Same thing, if you take your cursor, it is showing you the title open link page. If you click on it, it is taking you to the page link. Remember the link page that I showed in the previous video. So this is how the image tag is shown. Okay, I'll just show you once more the code. So you can see the code is ahref link, it is taking to the page link.htm. The title, that is when you take the cursor to the image, it is showing you the name of the title, that is open link page. You can see open link page is shown, and when you're clicking it, it is the width of the image is 30 and height is 30, it's very small as you can see, and it is taking you to the page link.htm. I'll just show you once more, it is taking you to the page link.htm. So this is how it is working. Over here, when you're clicking on the image is taking you to another part of the another web page. So this is how the image over here is acting as a hyperlink. This is an image hyperlink. On clicking this, it is taking you to a text hyperlink. Earlier we did the text hyperlink, and this is the image hyperlink. Please write down the code for the image hyperlink. This is the code for the image hyperlink. Same anchor tag is used. Instead of the text that you wrote over there, in place of the text we are just writing this code img, that is image source src equals to the name of the picture that is there in the same folder. You can give a width and height of the picture if you have to make the picture small, otherwise picture would have come really big, it would occupy the entire web page, which is not required. So you can give a width and height to the picture, and then just close the anchor tag. So only difference for image hyperlink is you're just inserting the code for the image, that is img src. So this is how you insert the image as a hyperlink in web page. I hope image as a hyperlink is clear to all of you. In the next one, we will do active link, a visited link difference, and how to insert those. So in today's video, you have learnt image as hyperlink. Write down the codes and also write the output. Of course, you don't have to draw it, but you have to make the output so that you understand what is the corresponding output or respective output for this particular code. Namaste, children.